Greg Nunn doing a terrific job on him. He is the player of the year defensively in the league.
Milton into Anderson, and the basket starting to come a little easier for Monmouth. Now they need some stops.
This one's going up for sure.
Johnson from the baseline, it'll go. 10 now for Rahsaan Johnson.
Nunn showing his quarterback tendencies, and there's an interception.
Crosby, long strides to the basket to lay it in. They're creeping back into it. St. Francis has been in control since about the midway point of the first half, but Monmouth is making a comeback right now. Timeout Terriers with the lead down to 10. Johnson gets by him, draws the foul, and hits the shot. They are back. Crosby for three. It's a 15-0 run for Monmouth. Milton gives it up. Anderson for three. Rebound, Bridgemahan. Spins to his strong side, but misses. Gets it back again. Yes! Great, great effort. A power forward at work in the paint.
And there are 12 teams in this league. In order to make the tournament, the league tournament, you got to be in the top seven.
Give and go, no, but the follow for Bridgemahan, and Dave Calloway was right on the money when he told us that he was their unsung hero. The last tie was 14-14, and the last lead was 14-11 for Monmouth. Crosby, they lead now. St. Francis, a remarkable comeback for Monmouth.
And that was a very, very tough shot from deep for a guy who had 0 points in the first half. He is exuding confidence. Crosby from deep on the penetration from his partner. And the lefty strokes it. Nothing but net.
Nunn will force it up. Got the rim, but Monmouth has the rebound, and Reyes fouls Johnson, so that's it for Reyes, and it sends the conference player of the year to the line at the other end for two.
This is mental at this point. And he is mentally tough. Owens happy.
Dominguez. Howard battling for it, ties it up, but the arrow favors Monmouth. Three-point game, 10 seconds left.
Inbounding the ball. Dominguez is trailing.
Howard to tie it.
He's got another shot at it.
Throws up a prayer, and Monmouth is going the tournament.
me. They lead now.
Three-point game, 10 seconds left.
Inbounding the ball. Dominguez is trailing.
Howard to tie it.
He's got another shot at it.
Throws up a prayer. And Monmouth is going to the tournament. And Monmouth has advanced to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1996 and just the second time in their history in a thrilling 67-64 win here in the championship game of the Northeast Conference.
Just got to believe, just got to work hard and maybe have a little luck. And all that happened for us, and it's just great.
Second half, they couldn't stop us for 40 whole minutes, and we started clicking, and we came too far to turn back, and that's all we just kept telling ourselves. We worked too hard.
We do this thing called the ladder that just kills us in the preseason, and we thought about that in the locker room. We thought about a whole lot of things. We thought about how hard we worked to get here.
Mama's back on top after a season, and people didn't predict us that well, and we really stepped up, and we knew we could do it, and we did it.
I'm just so happy for these guys to be able to experience this. It's just going to be a wonderful time, and we're just going to enjoy every moment of it.
Blue Devils, top seed, their number fourth straight seeding. They'll take on Monmouth.
You know, you're going to the best tournament that there is when you're playing college basketball and you're playing against the best team. So, I guess, you know, we're going to get our money's worth.
This is what basketball is all about. It's fun. So, I mean, we could be playing the Lakers. I wouldn't care. I'm ready to play, you know. Just to be here is what's good.
Actually, you know, with no better feeling in the world to go out and play the number one team in the nation and have an opportunity to showcase your talent in front of a national audience.
It was just an unbelievable feeling, first just to be in the tournament, and then when we saw we drew Duke, you know, everybody was very excited, but, you know, we just want to take it as a game and go out there and have fun and give ourselves a chance to win.
We didn't come here just to lay down and get ran all over. We came to play, and, I mean, we're going to go out there and give it our best shot.
They have players who know their roles, and they perform those roles very well. And I think that's one of the main reasons why they're champions.
Many people have told me that they have the winner of the Monmouth-Duke game to win the whole thing, so.
They are extremely happy to be here. It's only 7:15 in the morning, and look how crazy they are. We got the band, the cheerleaders. We've got it all. They are so happy. to be here. They may be the number 16 seed, but they are happy to be playing Duke.
We're just really excited to be here. The team's really focused. We're behind them 100%. Just really excited. Let's go, Mom, and here we go!
With one of the assistant coaches. Jim, why don't you tell that story again, because it's a good one.
Yeah, Ron Crail, assistant for 24 years. Back during the Vietnam War, he and Coach K played for the Armed Forces, or played in the Armed Forces together. And so a great story. Coach K talking to all the Monmouth players.
You know, I felt honored to go in there and play the number one team, and I felt like if you was going to go play anybody, then it probably play the number one team.
I look back at going to the dance. Probably won't watch the tape, but you know, I always remember it though. It was fun.
And they probably won't even realize how great it was until they graduate and 5 or 6 years down the road when they have somebody like this guy or something like that, and he gets a little older, they'll be telling how they schooled Jason Williams or Shane Battier.
What I want to be.
Got nothing against the big town. Still hayseed enough to say, look who's in the big town. But my baby.